at the outer Falmouth Belt near het Lonnekermeer. And there used to be a railroad crossing here that was unprotected. Well, guess what? It's gone. Yeah, the unguarded railroad crossing is no more. It has been closed. And well, I have to look where to walk, but as you can see, they put up a fence because ProRail wants to get rid of all these old unguarded railroad crossings. And quite recently, they have actually removed the large railroad crossing over there because they built a viaduct there. The road now goes over a bridge, so that railroad crossing is gone. And apparently they sadly have removed this one as well. Yeah, there used to be one here without any signals or safety. They just removed it. Very annoying because, if I wanted to walk in the forest, I always liked to use this railroad crossing. So it's pretty sad to see that it's gone, and well, it wasn't used all that often. And well, they just didn't want to invest the money to add some signals or some booms or some flashlight system because that costs a lot of money. So yeah, unfortunately, this railroad crossing is no more. But you can look in one of my older videos to have an idea of what it looked like. And let's switch to the other camera, to the Nikon, so that we can also film this a little bit differently from some different angles. Let's zoom in a bit here. But yeah, there is this actually a large viaduct in that direction. Let's see if I can get on top of this hill. It used to be accessible, but it's a very long time ago that you could actually really get on top of this, because this has become really dense and just impenetrable. Let's see how far we can get. But yeah, about a year ago or 2 years ago, the railroad crossing was still here. But sadly, it's Gonski now. So disappointing. But on the other hand, those unguarded railroad crossings, they were pretty dangerous, in fact. And a lot of accidents happened on them. And well, that's a reason why they want to get rid of them. And it costs a lot of money to just modernize them with signals and flashlights and such, because that costs at least €1 million, and they have to build all these detection systems, and they have to be reliable. It's just very expensive, and it's just easier to just close the railroad crossing altogether. Well, that's about as far as we can get. We can't get any higher here. It's just too densely vegetated. But yeah, I can't show the viaduct from here, unfortunately. When the railroad crossing was still there, I could have shown it. In fact, the new viaduct is actually pretty nice. But this is not the only unguarded railroad crossing here that they have closed, because 2 years ago they already closed a few in the area of Landgoed Oosterveld. There were four unguarded railroad crossings, and three of them have been closed because they were now made accessible with a new road, at least the farms. And another one near the Oosterveld itself also became redundant because they built a new road for accessing the house. So yeah, this is really disappointing. There is no railroad crossing anymore. But yeah, for people who want to wander in the woods, there is actually a path on the other side of the track, and there is a safe railroad crossing with booms and signals a few hundred meters from here, so it's not a big loss. I mean, you can still get behind there, you just have to cross about there and then go through the woods and then you can come out there. But yeah, so sad to see it leave. It's just sad that it's gone now. So I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. This was a bit quick and impromptu, but just I wanted to check it out. So bye bye. Well, that wasn't quite the end of the video yet. I just want to show a few things about the alternatives and where the other railroad crossings were. If we zoom in onto the area a little bit, you see here the location of where the railroad crossing is. This is where I just shot my video. There is no street view on this location, unfortunately. But yeah, it used to continue here in this woods. And then you could go here and then about here and then you could walk around the lake. And you would come out here. This is also a railroad crossing and this is the safe railroad crossing I was referring to. Let's see if I can get the street view working. Let's have a look. No, I don't think. Oh, actually there is a street view, yeah. There's just a photo here, but yeah, as you can see, this is the safe railroad crossing and the road I'm pointing here is actually the road that comes out on the unsafe railroad crossing over here that has now been removed. So that was about here. And there's a farm here and a country house in the woods and they just have to use this road and they can also come from here. And this road here goes to a cycling path that goes to the Hasseler S. That's a an area in Hengelo, just a housing estate, and I used to live there as a child actually in the 90s. And yeah, that cycling path that basically starts around here at the A1 motorway, and if you follow the cycling path you'll end up basically at those railroad crossings. So let's zoom in a little bit. Cycling path goes here and then you reach the safe railroad crossing about here, and this bit of road here is the road that goes to the one that has now been closed, which is this, and this is the hill that has been densely vegetated. But I said it's still possible to reach this point. Well, there is another way. You can simply go here and then here, and here is a nice walking track that you can use, and then you can still end up here in this lovely forest that is owned by Landschap Overijssel. So as I said, it's not really a big loss in that regard, and the viaduct has been built here. On this old street view location it is still a level crossing. Let's see if they've already changed it. Oh yeah, actually, yeah, this is the old level crossing and you see the viaduct is in construction there. Right now, as of December 2017, this is already gone and this viaduct is already in use. But there were more level crossings that were not protected or guarded, and that one was here near the Oosterveld estate. Yeah, there's no street view of that. I have once made photos of that in the mid 90s. And then there's a level crossing here that is a safe one, no street view. This was an unsafe crossing, this was an unsafe crossing, and this was an unsafe crossing. They are gone. Yeah, there's not even a photo. Let's see. Oh, maybe there is. Yeah, there's some kind of photo here. And let's check another location. This one here, Beuvinkweg. As you can see, that was also a unsafe crossing. These are all gone, but they managed to make these houses accessible by constructing a new road just around here alongside the track. So that's how they solved it. So yeah, that was a bit about the railroad crossings in the Lonnekermeer area. So, now we can finally conclude the video properly. I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching.